Hey everyone, Misty and Anthony here from Taste Winchester History, and we are coming to you today with a new video series that we are going to be doing called Tasting Tuesdays. So we are at
El Centro. We're down at the Walking Mall at the corner of Loudon and Boscawen. Today we're going to be tasting tequila.
I'm kind of scared. So we wanted to do this because a lot of people don't know that you can do tequila tasting at El Centro, and they have a giant menu. Look at all these tequilas. So we are doing two flights, Cabo Wabo and
Padron.
Patron.
Yes. Both are
pretty well known. We know Patron. Everyone knows Patron. So we wanted to do that one and then Cabo Wabo. So we're going to do a little bit of history about tequila as well, but I think everyone kind of has their own history with tequila.
Yeah.
It's either good or bad.
We won't go there.
We won't go there today. Now, El Centro is the place that I first tried tequila by itself.
Yes.
A few years ago. I'm not a margarita person. I think I'm one of two people that hates margaritas. And so, never tried tequila by itself. And then, had a flight here and kind of liked it.
Yeah, El Centro has all of the most popular selections. So, you really can't go wrong if you come down here.
Yeah. So, let's see if we can give you a little view here of the tequila. So we got a lot. That's two flights. Okay, so let's bring the camera back up here. So there are four different kinds of tequila, and it's based on how long they're aged after the distillation process. So tequila is very interesting because by law it has to be made in Mexico, and by law there has to be two distillations. No idea how they came up with that, but that's the way it is. And so if they bottle it after those two distillations, then we have Blanco or silver. So you'll definitely see bottles of that silver, Jose Cuervo, you know, Patron, all of those things.
Yeah, I'm partial to Patron silver. If I'm going to go to the liquor store and buy some, that's my personal favorite. So I'm interested in doing the others today and really comparing both brands and also trying to understand the nuances between each of the types of tequila that you can get.
Yeah, so the next level is, I'm going to say it wrong, Reposado.
That's correct.
<Let's go. laughs> And then the third is Anejo. So Reposado is aged between 2 months and 1 year in wood barrels, and Anejo is 1 to 3 years. And then they have Extra-Anejo, which is 3 years or longer. So you'll see the color differences. So,
it's tough. We got
Blanco.
It's very nice outside today.
Yeah, it is. Nice and bright, but you can see a little bit of color in there. And you'll also see gold bottles. I know we have Jose Cuervo gold at home, and that's basically a hybrid. So they do silver and then one of the aged ones as well to make it, give it a little color and kind of make it a little older. Okay, so are we ready?
I think we are. Okay. One of the things about tasting, the recommendation is if you're going to do formal tasting, that you should never do tequila tasting out of a shot glass. And that really
for
should
Americans.
Be done out of something such as a champagne flute that has to do with really capturing the aromas and the flavors and so on and so forth. But we don't have that luxury today, so we'll be doing the tastings right out of the shot glasses.
So this is the Cabo Wabo.
And
who was it?
With?
This is the Blanco. And who owned Cabo Wabo?
Well, I don't know. I think a big corporation, an Italian corporation, owns it nowadays. I forget which one, but I think it's Campari or something like that. But many of you who might know rock and roll, one of my favorite rock and rollers is Sammy Hagar, actually, originally owned all of the Cabo Wabo tequila company before he sold it. He sold his interest in it to an Italian company.
It's very interesting because it does have to be made in Mexico, but there are like 900 brands of tequila, and one of the statistics I saw was like 2,000 name brands out of those 900, so just like everything else, they, you know, white label them for different things. But they all have to be made in Mexico, and it has to be from the blue agave plant, not the cactus, and no other agave.
One of the reasons why I just realized that you want to try the tequila in a champagne flute, because if you have a beak like mine, you know, there's the whole aroma part of this exercise, and you really, the shot glass is too small, it really doesn't capture and I think highlight the aroma.
It goes down faster, too.
And it goes down way faster, too. So
that was the Cabo Wabo, which was pretty good. I think it's,
You know, we're not professional tasters, so we're just giving you what we're experiencing here.
I just think it's interesting because, like I said, I never really tried tequila by itself without anything else. And so it's not like, it's not burny, it's not, you know.
It's very smooth.
Yeah, it's very smooth. You get a little bit of a kick kind of in the back of your tongue. But it's very good.
How about flavor? What did you taste? I'll tell you, I was surprised when I'm actually paying attention to it. When you're doing a tasting, you actually try to pay attention to these things like aroma and taste. So what did you taste? Is there anything that stood out to you? I tasted black licorice.
Really?
I'm just telling you what I happened to taste this time around.
Maybe a little on the end, yeah, I can kind of see that.
But it was very good, very smooth. And yeah, that was the Cabo
Wabo. Cabo Wabo Blanco.
Blanco.
Guys, I don't speak Spanish. Can barely do an American accent, and I'm American. So this is the Patron, which is pretty much what everyone buys, Patron or Jose Cuervo. It smells very different than the Cabo Wabo. Way smoother.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, that didn't have a big kick, but that's like, it's almost like water. I mean, it's very smooth.
Yeah, and to me, a different altogether flavor. That's interesting. Yeah. Because they're both Blanco.
They're both Blanco, yeah. Well, I mean, they have, you know, just here there's, my goodness, probably from about 20, 25 different brands that you can try here. And then, of course, the three levels, Blanco, Reposado, I'll get it right, or Anejo. So, yeah, it's interesting to tell how different they are.
In Spanish, you have to roll your R's, so it's like Reposado.
Which he knows I cannot do.
So
I had to go to speech therapy in like second grade to even learn how to say my R. Yeah, I was a messed up kid.
But the other thing, when you're typically out and you see it on the margaritas, and you also see it when you're out on the town and you're drinking tequila like slobs, is they do the salt and the salt and the lemon or the salt and the lime. If you're coming out to really do a what I'm calling a formal tasting rather than just throwing back your tequila, you're going to do it without it. You don't want to end up poisoning the flavor profile with the salt, with the lemon, with the lime.
Yeah, in Mexico, they do not do the salt and lime. It's very much a sipping drink.
Yeah.
You just have it, you sip kind of like here you would do with whiskey or something like that. When we've traveled to Mexico, it's funny, they do kind of a tequila tasting or a toast at the end of like everything.
Yeah.
So when we've done like tours to see Cuba, like historic, you know, places, like they bring you back and you have a little tequila tasting at the end. So it's very interesting. So this is, it's funny because I think it's supposed to be kind of less tart as you go down because they're aged. So this was a Reposado, so it would be aged between 2 months and 1 year. But I think there's a little bit more of a kick on this.
You're gonna find out. Your eyes get a little glassy.
Yeah. Not bad. I think, you know, if you're a girl that doesn't really do liquor, I think this is pretty safe to try.
I would agree.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's
don't
not.
Don't be scared to come to do a tequila tasting.
Yeah, you're not. It doesn't taste like rocket fuel. It doesn't taste like poison. It tastes like you would be doing a tasting of wine or you'd be doing a tasting of vodka. They all have distinct flavor profiles.
Yeah, and we've done one before, and I don't even remember what kind it was, but it was pretty cute. They had little, it was like brown sugar rim. I don't remember what kind it was, though. What do you think of that one?
It was also very good. I'm just trying to figure out what it is that I taste. It's a different flavor, but nothing's jumping out at me.
No, it's weird because we do wine tastings and you can taste like the different fruits and the different wood or steel or whatever they did it in, but I think this is something to get used to. So you can taste those, be able to pinpoint them, but as of right now,
need bigger glasses. So we can take a couple extra sips.
Or a couple extra sniffs. It's hard to get
the smells on these little... Yeah, I can't get my nose. I can't get my nose anywhere near these. Cool.
Oh, this one's... The Patron all smell very smooth, and the first one tastes very smooth, so I think this one's going to be the same smell. Yeah. It's very cool.
Yeah?
It just smells smooth. Smooth out of smell. Who knew?
Yeah, the Cabo to me has a little bit of a sharper,
yeah,
sharper scent, and the Patron has, it's a little more subdued. It's not, that's the only way I can really describe it.
Well, I think they make Patron kind of for the main public,
yeah,
for everyone to like, so they tone it down somehow, I don't know.
Both very good though, I'm, yeah, certainly enjoying them.
So one of the... I think this is a female thing too. I think, I don't know, people look for the worm in the bottle. But in my research, I actually found that that's not a good thing. If it was an actual worm that was put there from the process, that's not a good sign. It's an infestation.
Well,
but it became a marketing gimmick.
And it's a marketing gimmick because we can do more research on it. It's actually the worm in the bottom of the bottle is in mezcal, not tequila.
Right.
Over time, people tend to cross that over.
Yeah, so that's why if you find it in the bottle, it's not from the processing. It's a full marketing thing. If it was from the processing, it would mean it was lower quality, which we don't want. So I thought that was interesting. Marketing, you know me, you know my background's marketing. I love all the tricks they use for everything.
Yep.
Okay, so the last one is Añejo. Which means it was aged 1 to 3 years, and you can see it has a bit of an amber glow. Let's see if I can get along the white back there. Oh, that doesn't help. That helps you a little. So it's a little darker. It's not that dark. You can definitely find the really dark ones, the extra Añejo, which is 3+ years. So this is the Cabo Wabo. This reminds me, you definitely get more of like the cognac, brandy, deeper smell. Which I love. I could just sit and sniff like brandy all night. Like I don't even have to drink it. Yeah, just sniffing it. It's like amazing.
Scotch.
Yeah. That's very smooth. Wow.
That's
the Cabo Wabo. Oh yeah. This is what I like about this stuff because you don't have to add all that stuff. You don't have to add all the juices, and like I said, I do not like margaritas. So.
And it is a sip and drink. You don't have to throw it back.
You don't have to throw it back. 15 shots in an hour.
Yes.
It's not, yeah, you don't have to do that. Okay, so this is the last one, the Patron.
I agree with you that the Añejo was really, really delicious.
Yeah. I don't think we've ever bought any, huh?
No.
We're gonna have to get a bottle?
Yes, we will.
Very good.
On the way home from El Centro, perhaps.
I have to take a look at their bar over there. Very nice. Cups are back by the bar. No one comes back here. I like having meetings, business meetings back here. No one's ever back here. Unless Jimmy's here playing live music. I don't know. There's not really much of a smell to this one. Weird.
No. And it could be, again, it could be the glasses.
Yeah, but
we're trying to
do. I don't know, there's it's like... Not,
you know, with the bulb of the wine glass, for instance, when you're doing wine tastings,
yeah,
that really keeps the aroma. It broadens the scent, it keeps the aroma in the glass, and it makes it really easy for you to get the nose. It's not really easy with shot glasses.
Again, very smooth. I don't think as much flavor as the Cabo Wabo. One of the other educational points, we're going to say this is an educational film. In the U.S., you cannot sell tequila that is less than 40% alcohol or 80 proof. But in Canada law, they can add water to their tequila bottles. Canada, what is up with that? Not cool.
I found the Patron, the Patron to have almost a little bit of a caramel finish.
Yeah.
and probably only
but still not as much flavor as the Cava Lava.
I agree.
Yeah.
Although I would drink any one of those six.
Yeah, like I said, I'm not, you know, I mean, he'll drink stuff that smells like nail polish remover. No. This stuff, come and try it. Even if you are not, you know, a liquor drinker, you don't do shots, this is something that you can just take a little sip, try it, share it with someone.
Yeah, you order a couple flights like we just did, and treat it like the sip and drink that it is, and I think you'll have a very different experience. And perhaps change your viewpoint on tequila.
Yeah, it's not just for frat boys.
Or frat girls.
Or frat girls. Of which we were neither, but you know, we can pretend. So come to El Centro. Obviously, we're on the walking mall. There's lots of other stuff, but we just wanted to show you kind of the things that people don't know.
Loudoun and Biscawen Streets.
Yeah, and of course, great Mexican food, which ours is waiting, so. We're gonna go eat.
We'll talk to you later.
Okay. Bye, guys.
Next Tuesday.
Next Tuesday.
Bye now.